Hello guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to the Core Java Interview Question Series. This is the second video in the series of a Core Java Interview Question Series, and this video will cover all the important and the top interview questions on OOPs in Java. Okay. So guys, I will discuss this interview questions on OOPs topic in two part, and this is the first part of the OOPs interview questions and answer series. So guys, I will suggest you to watch the lecture till the end, and before starting the lecture, I request you all to subscribe the XAdmin channel to get notification whenever a new video is uploaded. And guys, please hit the like button at the end so that it will encourage me to bring more awesome interview for you guys. Okay, so guys, Core Java interview questions help you in preparing for a Java based interview, whether you are a fresher or a highly experienced professional. Core Java plays a vital role in any Java or J2EE interview session. Core Java is a favorite area in most of the interviews and play a crucial role in deciding the outcome of your interview. And guys, OOPs topic is one of the favorite topic for the interviewer. So guys, without wasting any time, let us start the discussion on OOPs interview questions and answer. And guys, this is the first part of the OOPs topic, and the second part will come in the upcoming videos. So guys, please stay tuned. Okay, so guys, let us start the topic on OOPs interview questions and answer. So guys, what is OOPs in Java? OOPs is an object oriented programming, and guys, it is a way of a programming where the complete software work as a collection of an object interacting with each other. An object is a collection of data and a method that operates on its data, right? So guys, the second question may arise, like, what is the main features of the OOPs? And this is the most important question asked by an interviewer. Like, the main feature of the object oriented programming are as follows, like the encapsulation, polymorphism, inheritance, and the abstraction. And guys, you should know all these topics in detail, like what is encapsulation, what is polymorphism, what is inheritance, and what is abstraction with an example. Okay. So guys, the next question may arise, like, what do you understand by encapsulation? Encapsulation is a mechanism of wrapping the data, that is the variable and the method, in a single unit. The process of a defining properties and the operation for an entity, and it is declaring or defining a member for a class with the visibility labels and with a proper access modifier, is called as encapsulation. Okay. So guys, here the declaring private member inside a class is called as data hiding or encapsulation. For example, public class hello and a private integer a equals to 10. So guys, here private is used with a variable a, so it cannot be accessible outside the class hello. So guys, here we are using data hiding. We are hiding the variable a to access from outside this class hello. So guys, this is encapsulation and data hiding, right? So guys, the fourth question may arise, like, what is inheritance in Java? It is a process of defining a new class from the existing class functionality, right? In order to inheritance the existing class, we need to use an extend keyword. The main purpose of the inheritance is the code usability, right? For example, we can inheritance any class in Java by the syntax, like a class and the hello. Okay, so guys, this is a super class, and the class hi is a subclass which extends hello class, right? So guys, what is polymorphism in Java? It is a process of behaving one form differently in different cases. For example, consider television remote has a red button. It is used to switch on a television and also to switch off the television. In this case, a red button functionality depends on the current state of a television. If it is switch on, then it will be used to switch off, and vice versa, right? So guys, the polymorphism can be accessed in different ways, like a runtime polymorphism and compile time polymorphism. We can achieve runtime polymorphism by method overriding. So guys, by using the method overriding, we can achieve runtime polymorphism, and by doing a method overloading, we can achieve compile time polymorphism. Okay, so guys, the next question may arise, like, what is abstraction? And this is the important question. What is abstraction? Abstraction is a process of thinking before developing any program or any application. In other words, guys, abstraction is a process of defining properties and operation of an entity, like the properties related to a variable and the operation related to a method and an entity related to a class. So guys, consider the mobile phone, which is usually have two buttons, like one green button to receive a call and another red button to cancel the call. We are not bothered about how the implementation of the buttons are done and how they are working, but we are just using it. Okay, in Java, abstraction can be achieved through the use of abstract classes and interfaces. 100% of the abstraction can be achieved by using an interface. Right, guys? So what are the advantages of an abstraction? So guys, the advantage of the abstraction are as follows. Like, the abstraction reduces the complexity of a code, or okay, and guys, here we can do the reusing of a code also, right? And the third point is like it removes the duplication of the code, right? And the fourth point is like it helps to increase the security of a application, as only important details are provided to the user, right? So the next question may arise, like, what do you understand by abstract classes and an abstract method? So guys, this is an important question, like, what is an abstract class and abstract method? So guys, an abstract keyword is used to make an abstract class. Okay, so guys, if we have to make any class an abstract, then we have to use an abstract keyword. An abstract method does not have any implementation. So guys, the method which does not have any implementation, then that method is called as abstract method. In abstract class, the concrete method may also present. So guys, what is concrete method? The method which has the implementation are known as the concrete method. So guys, in an abstract class, we can have an abstract method also and a concrete method also. So guys, abstract method are the method which does not have any implementation are called as abstract method. So guys, in an abstract class, we can have abstract method and concrete method also. Okay, so guys, in a method defined as an abstract must be defined in a subclass. So guys, if you are defining any method as an abstract method in a class, then we must define that abstract method or, okay guys, in a subclass, right? If any abstract method is defined in a class, and then that class must be declared as an abstract class. And guys, if we have define any abstract method, okay, in a super class, and so guys, we have to override that method in a subclass. And guys, if we have not overridden that method in a subclass, then we have to define that class, the means the subclass, as an abstract class, right? So guys, an abstract class does not have any object. So guys, we cannot create the object of that abstract class, right? I hope you understand this point of abstract class and abstract method. And guys, this is the important question, right? So guys, the next question may arise, like, what is object in Java? To access the member of a class in Java, an object is required to be created, right? So guys, by the help of an object, we can access the variable members, like the variable and a method of a class, right? An object is also known as an instance of a class. So guys, the multiple number of an object can be created for a class. And in order to create an object, we need to use the new keyword. An object is a sum, like an object is a sum memory location in which each and every type of an information of a class can be stored in a digital code format. So guys, an object is used to access member of a class from outside a class, right? So guys, the next question is, like, what is a class in Java? Class in a Java is a user-defined data type. So guys, class is a user-defined data type, like a group of similar kind of entities. It is only, okay guys, it is only a logical concept, not a physical entity. Okay, in order to declare a class in Java, we use class keyword. For example, access modifier, class keyword, and a class name. So guys, here public is an access modifier, class keyword, and a hello is a class name. So guys, by this way, we can declare a class in Java. So guys, these are the some of the important question of a OOPS topics. And okay guys, so guys, I will discuss more important questions and the answer on the upcoming, the second part of this. Okay, so guys, stay tuned and please subscribe the X Admin channel, right? Okay guys, thank you and have a nice day guys.